Diamond is the hardest known material in the world, and a desirable diamond can cost thousands of dollars. But what makes diamonds so valuable? There are two ways to recover diamonds. Mining, where huge portions of earth are removed to expose deep underground diamonds, and sifting, where water and screens are used to filter out other impurities from diamonds. Each year, 3.5 million tons of rock are blasted to mine diamonds, and the diamonds recovered from mining and sifting are crude and look nothing like real diamonds until they are cut and polished. A true expert can see the potential of a crude, uncut diamond immediately by looking at its clarity and potential cut. Diamonds are actually made out of the carbon that existed in plants and animals living hundreds of thousands of years ago, which, over time, was buried far beneath the earth and exposed to extreme temperatures from the earth's core and pressure from the layers above. These extreme temperatures and pressure organize the lattice, or arrangement, of the carbon atoms, which produces the diamond's hardness, clarity, and stability. Some dwarf stars that contain carbon under high temperatures and pressure also contain diamonds, such as one found in 2004 that had a diamond weighing trillions of tons in its core. But how do colored diamonds exist? Diamonds that are tainted with different colors are actually colored by impurities, such as boron and blue diamonds, defects in the diamond's lattice structure in brown diamonds, radiation exposure in green diamonds, and little to no impurities in clear diamonds. Scientists have now even been able to recreate diamonds synthetically using heat and pressure in the lab. However, these diamonds are perfect and do not exhibit the sparkling shine that natural diamonds exhibit due to small impurities. For this reason, synthetic diamonds are not nearly as valuable and are used in industrial and military purposes, such as diamond-plated saw blades or bullet-resistant materials. Although diamonds actually are not all that rare, you're probably standing on top of some buried thousands of feet in the ground. Diamonds are expensive due to a phenomenon known as supply and demand. Put simply, if supply is greater than demand, the price of the supply will fall, and if the supply is lower than the demand, the supply will be desirable and there will be less of it, so it will rise in price. Since 65% of the diamonds sold in the world come from a single company, De Beers, which cleverly lets out only a small supply at a time to increase the price of all the diamonds in the world, supply is arranged low and demand high. Even rubies, which are much more rare than diamonds, are not as pricey because of supply and demand. The way a diamond's quality is determined is by the four C's: carat weight, cut, clarity, and color, with the most valuable being the largest and most flawless. The most expensive diamond ever sold is called the Pink Star, a flawless pink 25-carat diamond that sold for over $83 million. But the reality of diamond production is not so sparkly. Most diamonds come from South Africa, where workers slave away day and night without pay for the prospect of finding a single rough diamond that, with the meager sum of money they receive for it, allowed them to buy the next meal. These blood diamonds, so called for their origins with conflict, corruption, and bloody violence, make their way into the black market, which, through loopholes, makes its way into the global trade that has laws such as the Kimberley Act attempting to avoid such diamonds. Menial laborers produce many of the diamonds distributed throughout the world, so it is important to support organizations that fight to bring right to workers and only buy from retailers possessing Kimberley licenses.